Hello, Aku here again. Welcome to Feed the Beast Infinity. Today we are going to make a tier 6 altar, tier 6 orb for blood magic. Now, I was asked to do this as a tutorial type video a couple of episodes back. I was going to do it in a creative world, but I'm just going to do it in this episode. If it's not clear enough, please let me know in the comments and I will do a separate tutorial type video. But all I'm going to do in this episode, I'm going to keep it nice and clean. I'm not going to jump between mods and stuff. I'm going to focus purely on getting the tier 6 thing done. So the first thing you need, of course, to get to tier 6 is you need a tier 5. Now, there's two types of altar, of course, for tier 5. You can have a self-sacrifice like this, where we've got a feathered knife going here that's damaging me, and we've got regen. And that'd fill up an orb if there was an orb in there. There's not at the minute. So that's one way of doing it. And the other way, of course, is by using the Will of Suffering to kill mobs. Now, I've got that set up after last episode, so we'll head in there in a minute. A couple of things to do into here first, though. We are going to need to put an iron sword into our altar and turn it into a dagger of sacrifice. We're going to need this later on, but just going to make sure I get it so I don't forget it. So this is an important part. There we go. That is an important part. Dagger of sacrifice, you use that to kill stuff, and it kills things in one hit, and it doesn't mean any loot, it just adds blood to the thing, but we use that for a sacrifice dagger later on. Now the next thing we need is we're going to need to upgrade our activation crystal. So if you've done any rituals, you'll have a weak activation crystal. You make that, of course, by putting a lava crystal through your tier 3 altar. But for this ritual, because it's a high level one, we need an upgraded one of these. Two ways of doing this: we can do it with either a demon blood shard or a nether star. It just so happens I've got loads of nether stars because I've got that with the killer out in the overworld there. So I'm just going to grab a nether star. I just killed another 16. And unfortunately it crashed while I was killing one, so I actually lost one. Because the server crashed. Well, it didn't server crash, the power cut. So I'm going to put that in there, and that is going to turn this weak activation crystal into the upgraded one. So we're going to need that. There we go. So there's our Awakened activation crystal. As always, right click to bind that to you. There we go, that's bound to me. Then of course we need our eight. Oh man, this thing is too efficient. It's set on one by one as well. We're gonna need 8 of them guys. I've destroyed stuff. I seem to have, no, there they are. So that's from last episode, or was it the episode before, I did these 8 bell jars, each with their specific reagent in. And we're nearly ready to go. And I've got 128 ritual stones and a master ritual stone. That's all good. What I need to do now is I need to head down to where my pedestals are, because we now need to summon a demon before we do anything else. So I'm going to make it daytime so we've got no other mobs to deal with down there while we're down there. You can find out the recipes for all the demons on the Blood Magic forum page. But I'm just going to make the simplest one down here. So I'll come down here to where these pedestals are. This is the layout you need. If you remember a couple of episodes back, if I did 6 of these, I did 6 of these guys, 6 Sanctus, I would get a Holy Elemental, which is what I fought a couple of episodes back and it nearly killed me. And that's what you get your Demon Blood Shard from. So we don't have to kill one of them because we use a Nether Star to upgrade our thing there. What I'm using is 3 Sanctus, 1 Aether, 1 Terre, and 1 Tenebrae. What that's going to do is it's going to spawn us a Fallen Angel. Stop burning, fool. And when that spawns him, I've got to put myself out. There he is. And that's a Fallen Angel using. There we go. Because I've got a ridiculous weapon, I killed him in one hit. When he died, I got this Demon Crystal. We can use that to respawn him. We need him later on, so I can respawn him and I can kill him again. And it goes back into there, so we can summon him at will now. Now we've killed him once. That's what we also need the Dagger of Sacrifice for. Later on, when we kill him, we need to kill him with that thing. So I'm going to go now to where we're going to do the ritual. A couple of things I need to make sure I've got with me. I need my In my tool bag, I need my alchemic router. I probably need my cleanser, and I don't need my segmenter here, but I'm going to use it anyway. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to head to my place for the demon invasion. The demon invasion can go up to 1,000 by 1,000 blocks, so you want somewhere where it isn't going to run. If you're on a survey, you don't want it running over other people's bases and stuff like that. I'm doing it in an RF tools dimension, so it's nice and clean. I'm going to meet you there, because I want to change up where my spawn point is in there. I want to put my spawn point up in the air, in a little safe place, just so if it does get overrun and anything goes wrong, I've got somewhere safe to spawn into. So I'll jump into there, I'll show you what I mean. At the minute, I am down on the floor, on the ground. So, Demon Invasion ID7. Let's jump into here. So all I've done here is I've created a nice flat world so the demon invasion can spread out nicely. My stuff's on the ground down here. What I'm going to use is my angel block, and I'm going to grab some blocks from my AE system. I'm just going to move this up into the air a little bit, what you will do, and move these blocks. In fact, that's all I need to do, isn't it? So I'll get that done and I shall be back in just a moment. There we go, gone for a little minimalist one, and I've just come back and I landed safely on there. So I will spawn up here when I come back into this world. If I do die, I might have trouble getting down, but no, I won't, because my angel ring has got soulbound on it. Right, so what I'm going to do, I did grab a couple of extra things while I was back at my base there. I grabbed some alchemical relays and levers. These will be handy for us in a little while. What I'm going to do now then is I'm going to place the master ritual stone, and I'm going to place it right underneath this thing. So we're going to have this right underneath our thing there. I think that's a safe height. I think we should be fine with that. And our ritual diviner is in my bag, it must be. There it is. Is that set? No, that's set to the Will of Suffering. Okay, so I need to move that onto the Convocation of the Damned, which is what we're doing. Anytime now. There we go. And we're going to start placing 128. It's not placing them. Is it because of the plants? Okay, I need to clear the plants out first. Have I got a Horn of the Wild? I do. That's loud. Be right back. That seems to have done the trick. I've now got inventory issues. So I'm going to place down these 128 ritual stones. And as long as that green thing there, I'm slowing my right button down. I've got 128 ritual stones on me. As long as, hello pig, as long as that green thing there keeps spamming, and as long as your arm keeps moving, then you know you're not finished. So you can just hold the button down until you are done. And I've just realised I have not brought an altar with me, and I'm going to need one. So I'm going to chuck all this stuff over there. I can always get more of that stuff later. Go away, you and you. And I shall have to go back to my base because we need an altar on top of this. So, yeah, like I said, it's going to be smooth. Kind of smooth. Not 100% smooth. Because nothing ever is with my videos. A little bit close to that blood pool, but it shouldn't cause us an issue. Right. So now we need to put an altar on it, yeah? What we do is these dust runes on the top here, they are where our reagents are going to go. So let me just chuck all that stuff on the floor. I threw it on the ground. And we are going to put our eight, don't matter which order they go in, we're going to put our eight things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 around there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to put down our relays. And I want to leave onto the relays. I'm going to put the relays onto these dust runes. Oops. What am I doing? Unlock. 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'm going to put a lever next to them. 10 levers on so they're blocked for the minute. And now what we need to do is we need to feed each two of these into one relay, into the master stone. So with our, I'll do the first one on camera, with our router, we're gonna click in the air to clear it. We're gonna click on a jar, shift click I mean, on a jar, to set it to that thing, and we're going to right click on that to set that as the link and container, and we'll right click on that to set as a link thing. Then we have to click and do the second one. So we're already too late because we've got two lots going into that. Shouldn't matter because that is linked to it, you see. So when this one empties, then that one will start going in. So we are linked even though it's not showing it on there. So that's okay. So to clear that, so that's why you need to do it quick. What you could do is you could do the segmenter and set it so that, I'll do a segment on the other one. So check this out. If we go right click, set to potentia, that as one of the tanks set to potentia. Shift click to clear it. No, just shift right click to set that to tenebrae. Click that. We've got one set to tenebrae. So that's what the segmenter does. So now, if I link these two, only one of them tanks should fill up. So let's clear. Shift click to get that on. Right click. And one of them tanks should fill up, but the second one shouldn't. There we go. So now we're not in a rush. So shift click. And that second tank's gonna fill up. Lovely. That does it a little bit neater than that. But as you can see, because you can see the green graphic going to that, it is working. So I'll cut now. I'll get the rest of these four linked to this. Once we're linked to that, what we need to do is we need to then clear that. We need to right click that. That's linked to Tenebrae. Should not be no, don't need to shift right click that. Things are going messy. Let me clear this. I'll clear that. I'll clear that. Right, so now I need to set that to what this was set to. So this is set back to that, that's good. It's not very clear, is it? So right click. So if that lever was off, that's that feeding into that master ritual stone. So clear, shift click, then we'll link that to that. There we go. So ether and whatever that one was, Aquasalis, I think, can go into the master ritual stone. So I need to do that for these ones as well. So clear, set that back to whatever that is, potentia, and then use that as a start and that as a destination. Clear, set to tenebrae, start, destination. Yeah, so I'll do the other four. So when we come back, all these little light things should be going into these, and I'll also jump up to my base and make a quick altar because I'm gonna need one of them as well. So okay, we're good to go. I don't think I've caused anything to go wrong. You see, most of these should be showing two. That's showing two, and I believe all these are linked to this. So you can only put in so many at a time, so it's going to take a while to do this. What I'm actually going to do, I'm going to turn my sound right down because it's going to be noisy, so I'm going to go down to like 2%, so we can hear it a little bit. And what we want to do now then is we want to place a blood altar on there, and I did not bring any blocks. Let's get a bit of dirt to trap our 10 blocks will do to trap our demon in there. So we just need a little square. So as I've done this, when I've done this before, I am just going exactly how, well, trying to keep it exactly as I can to our way of time does it on his mod dev commentary. So that's to put our demon in when we sacrifice him. We've got to make sure we sacrifice him with that. So now what I can do is I should be able to activate this ritual. So this is going to take 15 million LP. So a rush of energy flows through. Let's check. There, we should be down at about zero. There we go, 4,000 LP left. I just checked there before I came. I was at 15 million. There we go. So that's going in. Now, what I can do, if I turn one of these on, that should start putting stuff in there. Do I have to have them all turned on? Oh, there we go. At least two turned on. So what we've got there is, there we go. Our ritual has started. Now this is going to take a bit of time. What it's doing is it's transferring the contents of each of these bell jars. Pigman. How did that pigman happen? That's weird. Is that a pig turned into a pigman? No idea. So, yeah, what it's doing is transferring the contents of each of these bell jars into the Master Ritual Stone. And it's going to take a bit of time doing it. It's not going to be massively quick. It's just going to keep working until they're all transferred in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut. So I'll come back when all these are empty. So we've got two empty already, look. That's down to... So look at one of our router, we can see the actual contents in there. We've just got that one that I maybe have to redo with a segmenter with a router to make it work right if I have done it wrong. But it seems to be going okay. I shall come back when that is all done and they're all empty. Okay, so I had a little bit of issue. These two got jammed up. So I must have done something wrong. And it says that one's going down now. That's the last one to go down. And that should be transferring through the relay now. See, the relay's got some in it still. So once this one goes in, this will go away. And that's what happened before, but these two haven't gone in. So what I had to do was I had to clear the destination using the cleanser on the relay and the ritual stone. I think I had to click the relay, but I clicked the ritual stone as well. So that cleared the routing, and I had to redo the routing using the router again, just from the relay to the ritual stone. So that ritual stone now has got all of these in. It should have. So what we can do now is we can summon our demon and drop him in on top of the altar there. Beep. Oops, not like that. Shift click him. And then make sure we kill him with a dagger of sacrifice on the altar. Bam. And there we go. That is now our altar. Now what I can try and do is I believe I can safely take as many of these as I can now. Oops, too late. But there we go. That is our demon invasion. So I'm going to rescue these few ritual stones just because it's a little bit of a time intensive process collecting, making ritual stones. So there we go. We've got there a demon portal, and we have got a nice little structure around it. Now this goes through several tiers. What we're going to start getting is these. This is a road that's just made, and I like the fact it's gone through this pool. That means the pool's not going to slow it down. I've got loads of ritual stones under there still. Let's have them. Oh, the master one as well. So I shall recover these. I should have maybe put my ritual in, spent a little bit more time and buried it down one block so it was a little bit nicer. We've got a building. You see the building over there? That's our first demonic building. Oh, look at this, very nice. That's new. So last time I did this, it's still a work in progress as far as I know, but it was more of a work in progress than it is now last time I did this. So we actually only got one type of building when I did it before. And my portal didn't form properly before because it was a version that was slightly broken. Whereas now, what should happen is our altar should upgrade itself at various points in the life of this. So there we go. That's the tricky bit done. The demon invasion is done. What have we got on here? An anvil. Ooh, got loot. What have we got on here? Iridium, some tin. Overgrowth seed from Britannia. Mega rubber sapling, very nice. Magical chalk. Some nice loots there. I shall leave them in there for now. Come back later. There is our first. Ouch. Nearly killed me, won it. Oh, Jesus. I think I need some kind of regen. Oh, man, that hurt. I have to be a coward and doing from up here. So, yeah, I'm going to have to get some kind of regen here, aren't I? But there is our 31-hit grunt. He should have about 200 hit points. And he nearly killed me in one hit. So I can't do this without regen, can I? I think I should have to make myself a blood pendant. A regen blood pendant. Because I'm not wearing a necklace. There we go. We have killed him. But what I didn't do was I didn't kill him with my blood sword. My bound sword. So what I need to do is make sure I can actually survive against these guys. And then make sure I'm actually using my bound sword, my bound blade, to kill these, because we need to kill them with a bound blade to get the loot off them we need for making our tier 6 orb and our tier 6 altar. So I'm going to come out of here for now, and I'm going to cut, and I'm going to make myself a little bit tougher, because that clearly I am not tough enough, and I should be back when I'm ready to go back in there. So yeah, what I could do is I could go and do pendant and stuff, but that means getting a lot further into Britannia than I actually am, so I'm just going to old school it. I've got a potion of regen, got a potion of strength. Let's see how tough this guy is. Just got another building up here there. Nice. So let's have a fight with this guy. That's not even a sword. That's not even activated. There we go. We managed to do him. There we go. We've got life shards. So there's two things we can get. We can get... Things seem too close. Oh, there we go. Things were too close, turns out. Two things we can get. We can get two types of shard. Got some nice stuff in there as well. Let's keep our eye out for these guys spawning. I like the well. I like the buildings way. Very nice. So as soon as these guys spawn, I'm wasting valuable strength two here. Because there's no one else to fight. As soon as these guys spawn, we need to jump on them and get them knacked. Now what we need. Keep half an eye on here, because I don't want to get shot in the back by one of these knobs. What we need, if we look at this, we need at least 5 of these minimum. We need 4 for our altar and 1 for our orb, and that's if we want to do 2-1. We probably want to do both our altars. To be honest, I don't actually think I need 2 altars. I think I've maybe done a bit of overkill with the altars, the fact I've got 2. There we go. That time we got some blue ones, so you can see these guys are quite generous. There's a police chase going on near my house. I don't know if you can hear the sirens over the mics, but there's certainly something going on. I've got 7 blue, 4 red. So what I need to do is I need to keep killing these guys with the bound blade until I have enough. Oh, there's one under there. What are they doing over there? Tell you what, I'm going to cut until them sirens stop, because they're getting louder. They must be coming right near my house. So I've just been back to my base again, because I was quite low. I fought 2 at once, one with a mess of me. They seem to knock the regen potion off you. Or I made the wrong regen potions. I didn't have no time on them. But I ran out of regen very quickly indeed. Seeing these, Britannia flowers. Look at that, there's double Britannia flowers. Basically, I had something new every day. Every time I update, there's something new from... I'm sure these are new. I've not seen these before. Look, tall flowers. Are doubles. Lovely. Right, we've got some more buildings, as you can see. Here's a new guy. Hello, new guy. If these hit me once, it triggers my regen, which is kind of nice. And of course, because I am giving them this weakness debuff. There, so one hit like that, I can kind of manage my health off my regen. That's off my revitalizing ring of shielding, of course. What I'm after there is I need to get up to 20 blue ones. I've got more than 30 red ones. So I've got enough reds. Now, I could chunk load this place. There we go. I've got enough blues as well now. I could chunk load this place and it'd grow a real lot. But at the minute, I can only fight one at a time. So I don't really want to chunk load it. As you can see, we've got some... Every building looks like now's been different by the look of it. That's similar to that one. Yeah, they're the same, aren't they? We've got 2 of these with the anvil in. Plenty of loot. I've got this little thing here with some melon by the look of it. Little tower thing there. So yeah, when I get a bit stronger, I will chunk load this and let it spread right out. At the minute, so fighting 2 was horrible because the range attacks. It might have been the range attack that was knocking the caution off me, maybe, I don't know. See, I should have really recorded it. There we go, I'm going to go back to the base now. And what I need to do now is we need to craft 5 of these things up. So let's get them crafted straight away. Why you do that? So let's chuck that stuff in there and let's have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. Now someone told me on my last episode, and god damn it, was it Sved? I can't remember who it was. I think it was Sved. If it wasn't, I apologize. If it was, thank you very much. Or whoever it was, thank you very much. Said that with a altar, a tier 6 altar. So what I need to do now is I need to make a tier 6 altar. So I need to get a load of slates made. And this is how my tier 5 altar got to at the end of last episode. The last episode there was no blood going in there because if you remember I had enough beacons for 3. I had 3 beacons, so this wasn't a tier 5. So nothing was happening. After the episode I made the 4th beacon and it was fine. I've ended up with 12 witches. And then in the comment it said 12 witches and every rune being a sacrifice rune is enough to make a tier 6 orb. So what I'm going to do is now we don't need these anymore, I'm going to change these for sacrifice runes. I'm going to make the next line of sacrifice runes out, that comes out to here, so it's 19 on each side, so I need to make 20, 40, 60, 80, so that's 76 plus 25 101. I need to get 101 more of these runes, and then these have I think it's about a 9 block tall tower that's going to be in the corner here with one of these on the top of each. So I shall get all that made, come back and we'll see if we get enough LP from 12 witches to make us a tier 6 orb as well. Let's see if I've done this right then. I've got enough this last row of these. See if I put them at the right height. So I think it's one higher and I've jumped dimensions too much. I've started to get lag spikes. One higher than the red ones. You need the purple ones. So we've got 4 in the corners there. So is this a tier 6 altar? Boom, it is. Excellent. So I've done that correct. We're still not ready to make our tier 6 orb yet because I've not got enough of these orbs. Oh man, I'll have to do a relog as well. I've got one. So what's that? I'm 24. So I need another 48 slates making. So I've got enough, there we go, one more there. I need another 48 slates so I can make another 24 of these sacrifice runes before we ever go put our crystal cluster into there and see if it works. So I'll do a quick relog to get rid of these lag spikes and hang around near my other wallet for a bit and we should be good to go. I have enough slates now then, so let's try this. I have just used my charm of dislocation to get myself here. I want to swap these out for these. So, 6, another 6. So we are tier 6, all, every single rune's a sacrifice rune now. So we should be maxing this out. So we're going pretty quick, aren't we, by the look of it. We're getting quite a lot of blood there. So I'm going to take this out. Make sure this guy fills up. We want this to be bang on full before we start. And that's full. Okay, so let's give this a try and see if it keeps up. That's sucking really fast. How's it doing? 7.6. Yeah, it's looking alright. It went back up to 8. Let's see if it keeps up. So when I did this in Direwolf 20, I used a self-sacrifice altar with speed rune, acceleration rune. In fact, it's all in my clipboard, isn't it, what I used? I used 8 speed runes, which I've got 14 dislocation and 19 acceleration, and the cry of the eternal soul ritual to get enough LP transfer rate to make this. So I wasn't expecting this to work. Of course, before, whenever I use this, I normally only have 8 witches and not 12, so the extra 4 witches might be enough. Is it gonna do it? Oh, we've got a little grey Got a little grey cloud there, we're starting to run out. I don't think it's going to make it. Is it getting enough? Is it getting enough? So, when it gets that little grey cloud there, it's actually losing a little bit of progress. So, is it actually still going up? Or is it kind of like losing more than it's getting back? That's the question. So I guess I need to watch this for a little while. See what happens. Of course I could just add more witches. It's like not like there's unlimited on space. I could have another 12 if I wanted. Nice little tip from someone with a pig in the name. Oh yeah, it worked. Awesome. Whenever I use these witches, I put them in a jail of safari net. If I move them, I always put them back in a jail of safari net. Once they've been in a jail of safari net once, they can go into a normal safari net and they'll still not despawn when we take them back out, so that's all good. So there we go, we have got a tier 6 transcendent orb. Sweet, link that to me. Put that in there, that's going to start filling up. So our altar now has a capacity. So it was at 10 million capacity. We're back up to nearly 5 already from being down at 0. That's how long it took me to get the slates back together. We were at 15 when I had the runes of the orb in. They're all out now. So we would have been back to 10. I believe this puts us to 30. So we've got 30 million RF. And it was indeed spared, who let me know that this can get enough LP in there to make your tier 6 orb. So it's a bit, it's far more straightforward than doing it the other way. And of course, if you, this means I only need one altar. So I don't actually need the self-sacrifice one. I could just use this for making slates and stuff as well. So I've actually, now I know how to do this, I probably wouldn't have bothered making two. I would have just made the one. Yeah, I would have. So there we go, we have got a tier 6 orb. I'm going to keep the episode short. I'm going to finish it there because I say I wanted to keep this episode nice and clean just on this tier 6 altar and orb mechanic thing. One thing I do want to mention, JTY, I don't know how you pronounce his name. McJTI or McJitty, the modder for the mod maker of RF Tools, left me a very nice comment on the last episode to let me know that what you can add to your RF Tools dimensions so they do not drain power when you're not in them is a block called a, what's it called again? Oh man, what was it called? I've made one, and I can't remember what the damn block's called. RF Tools, I recognise it when I see it. It is called... just going to have to go look at it, are we? Because my memory is like a goldfish. Monitor or something, it's not a monitor. Oh, god damn it. Okay, let's just head back into... we'll still link to it anyway. Head into the Demon Invasion. Like I said, I will chunk load this and let it grow properly. There we go, it's called an activity probe. So I've changed that around a little bit. I've added an activity probe onto there. So what that does, while I'm in here, it does nothing. It's using power like you'd expect it to. Get away, ranged attack, ouch. Come here, you. Oh, okay. I fell in the blood. I'll have these two earth demon grunts. So when I've done these before as well, I've had ice ones, I've had fire ones, first time I've had earth ones. That's pretty cool as well. So no change yet there, but you wouldn't expect much of a change because we're still quite a small little invasion here. When it grows, when it tears up and stuff, the roads change, I believe, to nether brick and stuff like that. It actually gets more, it actually looks prettier and stuff as well, or more demon-y, let's say, rather than prettier. Let's head up here. So yeah, we've got this thing, activity probe. Well, if we come back now to the overworld, what we'll see is while we was in there, that'll have been using power, but because I've got that activity probe there, what I can do is I can come across here. If I take the tab out of the builder there, you see the power's not going down. If it was chunk loaded, it would be, I guess, or if anyone was in there, it would be. But because no one's in there, the well's unloaded, and it's not using power, which is very awesome. So it only uses power when we're in there. It will use power because I'm going to chunk load it, but at the minute, it's not using power. Great stuff. So I'm gonna leave it there. Little short episode. I hope I didn't dep around too much and made it clear what we was doing. So a quick look at the clipboard. So we have done Demon Invasion. We've done a tier 6 altar and orb. So that's both done. Complex mining spell, again, I want to do it, but this mining solution I've got is crazy enough as it is, I think. I don't think I'm going to get any real benefit from putting the time into doing that other than to show it. And all I'm going to show is exactly the same one that Peppermint has shown. So I could just link you to his chat, his episode where he shows it. Yeah, processing cell is what we're on with next. I want to get all of this stuff, all this processing stuff here, all this non-AE stuff into a cell. I have been asked to do a video on the parallel Ender IO alloys processing. I'm going to be setting up a cell for that as well, so I may do that as an episode of this, or I may do a little standalone creative episode where I do a setup using load of sag mills, a load of alloy smelters, set an alloys mode to and steel factory manager to automate the parallel processing of loads of alloys at once, like loads of vibrants and stuff. But I'll talk about that more next episode. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode, and I hope I see you next time. Cheers, bye.